I just thought "Collect the Soul of Morocco" in the same sentence sounded good. Palace. Back in the day, this place was pretty beautiful. It had a lot of marble, and now they're kind of rebuilding it.
When was that, 1578?
Yeah, I think it was built in the 15th century.
That'd be 16th.
1578
would be
16th. Really? All right, Mr. Century Correction Man.
This was the place, wasn't it, in the day? It's been looted since then, and now they're restoring it.
It was actually built with slave labor, too, which is kind of creepy. But
you can't understand how something that huge was ever built. And then you kind of go, wow, I would have cut it in half. That'd have been plenty of space for me. And, you know, cut the time down to 8 years instead of 16 years to build this place.
Today, we found ourselves in the dungeon.
Is there a way to get a light? Let me see that thing.
What do you see? You want?
Okay.
It's a bug.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's safe to say.
That's where they had the shackles.
I think it's safe to say that people like probably died.
You think that's where they had shackles? Shane's gonna give you the official shackle pose. Here it is.
I meant to do no wrong.
We had some bonding moments. We walked through the dungeon. And,
are there secret passages?
Probably not anymore.
Right here?
Oh no! We're going through the same place. We're lost.
Dungeons should naturally give you a weird vibe, but we were starting to have fun.
Bad spirits didn't bring us down. Maybe it was a fun dungeon.
Maybe, yeah.
That's good. A prisoner. Look. Well preserved, I might add.
What is your favorite color?
Green.
Wrong. 15 more years.
We grew up together. We've known each other our entire lives. And as adults, we've lived on the road together. And we have like our own language and we our own humor. Conversation that is dead.
Here in Morocco, and but the catch was, you know, we're going to play acoustic, which for a rock band, a little different. We don't practice acoustic too much.
Yeah.
And we didn't before we came out here. We just
did not practice acoustic. Just came out here and kind of created as we went.
You know, we're all pretty good musicians, we feel. we can make anything happen.
You do.
Yeah, I believe in us. Got to Marrakesh and we went to the market, the souk. So started to venture out a bit.
Everything we see here is self-contained within Morocco, or do y'all bring it in from outside?
It's Moroccan 100%.
They got some badass jewelry here, that's for sure.
When you first start going through the market, it's very overwhelming.
I don't think there's enough to choose from in here. You think they got any more in the back?
You know, it's like, oh my gosh.
Moroccan traffic jam.
Gloria Stefan.
Skin tight.
One small honey bun. One.
Oh, sorry.
My bad.
You all right? It's a nice head.
Oh, yeah. Now I know why there's so many bees around there.
It's good.
Cows here. There's hats over here. There's shoes over here.
Moroccan slippers. Carlene, I believe, is his name. Hey, buddy. You got some Spanish fly?
No, not Spanish fly. Viagra. That's the father of Viagra. Right.
Viagra. For Will.
Like tea? Black tea. To drink it about 2 minutes is guaranteed, my friend.
How much?
That's cost $3 for 1 gram, my friend.
Why is he doing that?
For one night.
One night, okay. Moroccan Viagra. No, that'll be fun.
This is Moroccan Viagra. This is for men and this is for women.
Evidence for customs, right here.
Some guy made a dominoes out of his feet.
That's amazing.
He didn't touch it with his foot, did he? His foot was on the thing, because I put this in my mouth. I'm kind of freaking out all of a sudden. This was on the spool, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
No, it wasn't. Just the whittle part.
Really?
Yeah. Don't make me throw up.
Handmade guitars and hand drums. Very killer sounds.
Sure.
More importantly, yes, the hand drums.
How can I get one of these back home? How can I do that? I don't know if the cameras can really do justice for how tight the shops were and how many people were in the souk. Great smells of the spices and the great smells of Marrakesh.
Thank you.
One of the locals. How you doing, sir? Doing good?
That is a Pink Floyd song, isn't it?
Sure, yeah, it is. Don't.
Monkey thing's a little fearful. That freaked me out a little bit.
I ain't no mice.
No.
I don't want to touch the monkey. Damn, get him off.
Get it off.
Oh, keep him there. Keep him there.
That started way back when I read Pop's.
Get him off.
Thank you. So I'm already thinking, okay, I'm in Africa, there's a monkey on me.
Don't want a monkey on me.
I love dogs. I haven't seen a dog yet here. Has anybody seen a dog? Seriously, have you seen it all?
Except for the, you know, we do the double course at the end.
And then the second time on the double course.
We bring it up.
That's when
we'll
I
figure it out.
Just setting in right this moment.
Yeah,
it stings a little bit.
I have a low tolerance for pain.
Mm.
You did
monkey,
not.
Monkey doo-doo.
So it stays on for like an hour. And I guess the longer it stays, the deeper the stain goes.
Second. Ross got bird doo-doo in his head on that tape. Can we get the shot of his... Oh.
And I feel this bonk. And I look up, and there's birds flying over my head. It's like caca. Caca. Bird caca. Yeah, look, the birds.
Oh, oh my God.
So I'm playing.
Somebody, everybody's in
it. I cannot believe that.
Why drink the water from my hands? Contagious as you think. Just took my son to what your domain. Your cup running over again. Don't scream aloud. Don't think aloud. I'll turn your head now, baby. Just think. Just spit me out.
start off on a trek across the Atlas Mountains to get to the Sahara. Definitely a treacherous drive, looking over the cliffs and stuff. We got to a new morning. We took one little turn, and all of a sudden, there's big dunes. By my side. And I don't need any warnings. A little further down the road, there's a herd of camels with saddles waiting for us.
Now pick a camel, gentlemen. Stand next to your camel.
That's it. Piss mine off, will you? Okay. That's it.
Okay, Joyce, next.
Kind of scary, but once you get into it, you realize, you know, there's nothing to be afraid of. People have been doing this for hundreds of years, riding around on this camel.
Changes to make me love today.
Good news.
You couldn't bring me heaven.
First camel ride?
Ever.
That's great.
Beautiful. Ever.
First animal ride, I think.
Wow, this is cool.
I'll start here.
And then go there.
This is a campsite.
Look how beautiful it is. I'm amazed.
Camp out. We haven't camped out in a while. But there's nowhere to sneak off. You just camp out and sneak off to some girl's house. There's nowhere to sneak.
No girls.
You couldn't bring me heaven. Heaven's already here.
Cool. I got it.
That's good stuff.
I got it.
That were there working, you know, with cooking our meals and things like that. They just came and they hung out with us. Neither one of us could really understand each other because of the language barrier, but when you're sitting there and you're playing drums together, there's a whole different level of communication. One of our main goals in the evening was to keep the campfire going. You know, it becomes like a challenge. Okay, you know, where do you find wood in the desert? So we're
gonna... You realize there's no trees around here.
Right. So we kept the campfire going almost all night. I don't think we got any sleep. We enjoyed it tremendously.
It's a classic scene, the guitarist. The vocalist around the campfire, mm-hmm. In the middle of the Sahara.
Got a photograph of a smile taken way back when we could smile. Now this plane will take me.
beer.
And that is the loop.
It was incredible. It was cool. Campfire was awesome. And it just...
Our performance, slowly, who knows? It doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. It was just like a cool experience.
She said the time is unfair to a woman her age, and now that wisdom has come, everything else fades. So she realizes that she's seen a better days. So she can't look back to her days of youth. What she thought were lies, she later found was true. She said her daddy had dreams, but he drank them away. And a mother's to blame for the way she is today. Life's river shall rise, she said, only the strong shall survive, she said, but I'm feeling quite weak, and she said, will you comfort and forgive me, she said. She says she's still searching for salvation's light. Yes, she wishes all day, and then she prays all night. She says she won't speak of love, cause love she's never known. And it's moments like these she hates to be alone. Life's river shall rise, she said, that only the strong shall survive, she said, but I'm feeling quite weak, she said, will you comfort and forgive me, she said.
We went to, it's called Eid Ben Hadou, and it's actually like a Casbah built into a mountain.
We're climbing to the top of a 700-year-old Moroccan fortress. It's pretty incredible.
But this? 12th, about 12th century.
Really?
This one's about 12th century?
No, they are fulfilled in this 12th century.
The 12th century?
Yeah.
So, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, I want to be.
Wow.
Hey, Ed. Hey. Practice, right?
He is pissed off. Dang, he's mad.
What's up, buddy?
Okay, now let's say you're living in the fortress and you're 7 years old and you got a game of hide and seek going. I'm talking about right in there. Nobody's gonna find you.
It's almost like an abandoned mansion, in a sense. I guess that's the best way to describe it. And once again, you talk about a maze. I mean, it's like you have to have another guy to get in and out of there.
Hey.
Yeah. Helicopter, helicopter.
Yeah.
The most incredible thing about this place is it's all made out of mud, stone, and hey. Choose the wise path. The wise path is the path of righteousness. Watch your step.
The view from up there was amazing. That's the first time I really got a picture in my head about the landscape.
He's the first man up.
I'm the first one to the top.
Because you're driving so flat in the desert. And then when you got a little elevated, you saw the mountain. You actually saw the beauty of the land.
This place is built up here on this mountain. They could see the caravans coming through. They would tax the caravans from the Sahara.
We got a guide also, babe. We know it too.
I just thought collective soul and Morocco in the same sentence sounded good. You know, more rock.
Look at this. Been around for a long, long time. Hundreds of years, and it's still here. And the people, I think, are relatively the same. So that says something for their whole culture, their way of life. They're able to preserve it.
I think America in general has an impression, a certain view on Islam, and I think it's wrong. You know, it's a wacky, it's just all this preconceived notion that it's these guys with backpacks that blow things up, and it's so wrong. Seriously, you don't ever get to see, get to see what they are, real people.
Yes.
With a beautiful religion, and yes. And you know, hopefully people can understand that a little bit more.
And we just got back today from the Sahara. And I don't even think it's really sunk in, you know. I'd like to, you know, months from now, I guess I'll look at the pictures and be like, yeah, that was the Sahara. I guess it was about 5 a.m. We were still up in our bunks, and they started the prayer over the loud system somewhere out in the Sahara. The little village was pretty far away from us, but you could hear the prayer as clear as anything. And we just got out of bed and started looking at the stars and listened to the Islamic prayer. We don't even have any idea what it was, but it was beautiful.
Give me a word, give me a sign. Show me where to go, tell me what will I find. Show me where to go, tell me what will I find, what will I find.
playing Shine anytime to me is a good moment. We're very appreciative of where we are. We worked very hard to get to this point. And then to sit there and play it and we're in Morocco, you know, it kind of goes. And the reason we are there in Morocco is because of that song.
I'm looking forward to getting back home, but I feel like I've gained some knowledge to a certain degree by coming here, and that's, you know, that's a refreshing thought, just to know that you've gone somewhere and you've seen a totally like different culture from where you're from.
Well, as far as writing and inspiring to write, I know it'll inspire us. I mean, we write all the time, and there's no way you can't come to something like this and experience it and go, oh, you know what? Can't be ho-hum about this. This has been an unbelievable experience.
We still to lose every color from the sky. Then crawl as a child while the shadows burn. No longer shine on this burn out rainbow. Lately, it seems we've been chasing what time's resolved. Or maybe something means nothing here after all. Whispers. Now screams, this conclusion never ends. My pride with your kiss, even angels can't defend. We know we're running head on into our plan. Time's resolved. Or maybe something means nothing after all. We hide, sit behind these crumbled walls.
us we know. There's nothing more here after all.
To go behind the scenes and experience more of this episode, or to order great Music in High Places collectibles, log on to musicinhighplaces.msn.com and be a part of the adventure.